welcome back to Rubber Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be working on a Dodge, Jeep or Chrysler vehicle. So if you have any of the three vehicles and you have, guys, two specific codes, stay with us, we'll discuss which codes those are. We'll show you guys how to fix that. Let me introduce you to the channel, guys. Every Dodge, Jeep, Chrysler we get at the shop and every car will make at least 200 videos. So our mission, guys, is to save you as much money as we can. Let me just start by showing you how the engine light is on. I cannot give it gas. Okay, and sometimes you might be able to give it some gas, but in our case, I can't. Check it out. Engine light on, powertrain light. Okay, blinking there. So definitely a problem with the something with the that controls the engine. So I'm going to turn the engine off now. I'll turn the ignition only. Okay, that, guys, will work on any Dodge Chrysler vehicle that uses the throttle position sensor. Okay, with the ignition on, okay, you can see like that, with the ignition on, let me show you now, we're going to be using the MaxiCom here. You can find this scanner listed in the description of the video below for your convenience. You can find where we got it from. Okay, you can fix not just Dodge Chrysler and Jeep, you can do so much with that thing, it's unbelievable. So, I'll go back, we'll clean VIN detection here, auto detect. What it will do, it's going to ask us to select Dodge or Chrysler, ours is a Dodge. And it's going to decode the system now, the VIN number, and tells us which vehicle we have. So you don't have to manually select that. Okay, you can see, like that, 2012 Dodge Journey, yes. Now, we're going to go under diagnostics here, we'll select control unit, powertrain, that's where the engine computer is, engine control module, because engine light is on. And we can go ahead and read the codes now. Check out what we're going to get. Okay, our battery is running a little bit low, it says active, it means that the codes are still there, P2122, P2127. Both of them are related to accelerator pedal position sensor. Where is your accelerator pedal position sensor, guys? Okay, in most cases, okay, let me turn the ignition off. In most cases, okay, that throttle accelerator, the gas pedal, this is your throttle position sensor right there. So in order to remove and replace it, you have to get a whole new pedal, the whole assembly. So we have the video on the channel how to replace them. They're pretty simple, so please check it out. We're going to replace ours and see if that fixes the problem now. So, I'm going to go ahead. Okay, start the car now. Engine light is still on. That's after we replace the throttle position sensor. But I can give it gas now. What I'll do, I'll turn it off. I'll turn the ignition only. Ignition only. Now, if we go back, we'll select erase code, ignition on and engine off, yes. And now if I go and read the codes again, I shouldn't have anything here. And check out if we go under live data here quick. Okay, we can select, okay, this is your throttle position sensor. It says 7% now. So if I start the car now, no engine light on anymore. Check it out, guys. We reset it. Everything's great. And our throttle position sensor works. You can see how it changes. So that definitely fixed the problem on this Dodge. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.